Very good morning and Jai Hind children. Welcome to your chemistry class. Children, we were doing language of chemistry. So we'll continue with this language of chemistry and we'll learn something new today. Alright, so we'll learn what are that table that you have drawn in your fair notebook, that is table 3 and table 4. We'll talk about that today. Okay. So children, in the previous class we have studied about valencies. We have seen different valencies of elements and we have seen how the naming of compound is done when we have elements. Alright, now we'll learn something more today. Okay, before that I have given you the homework of to solve and write the formula of certain compounds that we will discuss later. First we will study something more about the radicals, what are electronegative radicals, what are electropositive radicals. So children, today you will be requiring the language of chemistry book. So please open the language of chemistry book and open table number 3 and table number 4. We'll talk about radicals. And children, before that, I hope now everybody knows first 20 elements and their valencies. If not, I'll just quickly give you a trick to learn the first 20 elements and their valencies. So first let me discuss that. So first we'll talk about the first 20 elements and their valencies, how you can learn it quickly. Children, to learn this first 20 elements, there is also one trick. You can write various formulas and something like that I'll tell you later when the class opens. I will not tell you here. Okay, but I'll tell you how you can learn the valencies. There is one trick, very easy trick, that you can by that you can learn these 20 valencies. Let's quickly start. So everybody ready? I hope this table you are having, I have already sent you this table. I hope everybody is having this table in their fair notebook. I have asked you to draw it. So I hope everybody is ready with this table. And now can we start? So children, pay attention. This is very, very, very important and easy trick to learn the first 20 valencies of the first 20 elements. So children, pay attention here. Let's see. Helium is 0. Okay, so these are the compounds that are present in the last column of periodic table that are having the complete octet, jinko kisi bhi electron ko lene ki aur dene ki zarurat nahi hai. They are their compounds. Let's focus over helium. It has 0. Neon, it has 0. Then coming on to argon, it has 0, isn't it? So these three, this helium, neon and argon. Helium is at second position, neon is at 10th position and argon is at 18th position. So remember this: helium 0, neon 0 and argon 0. Alright, now 0 ke baad aapko kya karna hai? You will just have to write 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, you will write 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, where is 0? Here is 0 for neon. You will write 1, 2, 3, 4. Written? Got it? So these are the respective valencies. After 0, write 1, 2, 3, 4. Done? Here also, after 0, write 1, 2. Clear? So we know we have to just learn where 0 is. So at second position, helium is there, it is having valency 0. At 10th position, we have neon, the valency is 0. At 18th position, we have argon, the valency is 0. And 0 ke baad hume kya likhna hai? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also, 0 ke baad, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also, after 0, we have 1 and 2. Isn't it? Clear? Ab leftover ka kya karenge? Ab dekhiye. This is first 0, so kya humne likha? 1, 2, 3 and 4. Ab yahan niche se dekhiye. 0 hai, so we will write it in a reverse order. Upar se niche likhe, like 1, 2, Then we have 3, 2, 1. Are you getting it? So we have 0, 0, 0. From upwards, we'll write 1, 2, 3, 4. From downwards, we'll write 1, 2, 3. Again, 0, 0. From upward, we'll write 1, 2, 3, 4. From downward, we'll write 1, 2, 3. Are you getting it? So by this, you will learn these valencies. Okay? But to learn and to write these valencies, first you should learn all these elements. This is very important. Agar aapko ye element nahi yaad rahenge series mein, to aap isko bhi gadbad kar denge. So first you should learn these first 20 elements and then you will write the valencies. Okay? So we have 0, 0, 0 and then after 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. From below we have 1, 2, 3. Again, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. From below we have 1, 2, 3. Got it? So, by this way, this is a very small trick if you are getting it. Please do learn all these valencies. This is very, very, very important to learn. Alright? So, this is a small trick to learn the valencies of first 20 elements. We also have a trick to learn the names of these first 20 elements, but that I'll tell you later. Alright? Please do learn all these elements and valencies. Children, now please open your book, open language of chemistry book. We'll go through the table number 3 and table number 4. So children, when you open this page, I think the page number is not mentioned. Please open this page. This is chapter number 2, symbols and formulas. Open table number 3. Children, when you will open this table, you will see the heading as basic or electropositive radicals. And table number 4 says acid or electronegative radicals. So children, now we'll first understand what is radicals. Then we'll go through what is electronegative and what is electropositive radicals. And we'll try to learn all these symbols and all these names. Alright. So children, today's class is very, very, very important. So please be attentive and listen to me very carefully. So children, we'll first talk about radicals. We have gone through the crisscross method of writing formula in the previous class. By the same way, we'll do for the radicals also. First, let's see what is radical. So we'll talk about radicals. So children, what is radicals? Radicals are the group of atoms, group of two or more atoms combined together to form a single unit but with a positive or negative charge. Humne compound padha hai. What is compound? Compounds are also a group of atoms or element. Compounds are group of elements we can see. Alright. In the same way, radical is also there. Radicals are also group of elements or group of atoms. These are also group of atoms. Alright. These are also groups of atoms like compound. Alright. But what is difference between radical and compound is, compound is neutral. Compound kya hota hai? Neutral hota hai. Whereas radicals are having charges. Radicals are having positive and negative charge. Okay, I'll give you an example. Let's take example of H2O. Let's take example of H2O. Very simple. H2O. Alright, we know that the valency of hydrogen is plus 1. Isn't it? And we know that valency of oxygen is minus 2 or 2. Remove 1. Let's talk about the valencies. So the valency of hydrogen is 1. We know that. And valency of oxygen is 2. Okay. Valency of hydrogen is 1. And valency of oxygen is 2. So let's see this compound H2O. Whether it is getting neutral or not. So we'll have plus 1 here and we have minus 2 here. So if we multiply it, we total have 2 and here also we have 2. So this will get cancelled. So this is a neutral compound. So this is what? This is neutral. H2O is neutral and hence H2O is compound. It is not a radical. Got it? Now let's see few examples of radical. Are you getting this? Radicals are group of atoms and they have certain charge, either positive or negative charge. Alright, they are called radicals. Clear? Now let's take few examples. So I am taking one example of electropositive radical and one example of electronegative radical. Okay, so there are two types of radicals. One is electropositive, another is electronegative radical. So there are two different types of radicals. Got it? So now let's take the example of a positive radical. So let's take the example is NH4+. So what is this NH4+? NH4+ is ammonium ion. What is NH4+? NH4+ is ammonium ion. Got it? Let's take one example of electronegative. This is OH-. What is this? What is OH-? OH- is hydroxide ion. What is OH-? OH- is hydroxide ion. NH4+ is ammonium ion. OH- is hydroxide ion. So, because it is having a positive charge, we are telling it as electropositive. Because it is having a negative charge, we are telling it as electronegative. Alright. Now, you will ask me, ma'am, how this positive charge and negative charges are here? कैसे हम उस पे पॉजिटिव और कैसे हम इस पे नेगेटिव लगा दिए कि हम ऐसा नहीं कर सकते कि उस पे नेगेटिव और उस पे पॉजिटिव लगा दें. सो हियर इज द आंसर फॉर योर क्वेश्चन. सो वी विल टेक वन बाय वन. सो लेट्स टेक फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रोपॉजिटिव, दैट इज NH4+. सो व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू इज will calculate the valency and accordingly will mark the charges. Okay, so the valency of nitrogen is kids. Valency of nitrogen is, it is -3. The valency of nitrogen is -3. Valency of hydrogen is +1. What is the valency of hydrogen? The valency of hydrogen is +1. Got it? So let's calculate the valency of total this radical. Are we ready with this? So children, let's see. The valency of nitrogen is -3. Got it? Hydrogen ke char hai yaha pe. We have H4. Ek ki valency 1 hai. एक की वैलेंसी 1 है तो 4 की वैलेंसी क्या होगी. सो विल मल्टीप्लाई +1 × 4. सो इट विल बी -3 + 4. इजंट इट? इट विल बी -3 + 4. आर यू गेटिंग इट? यस. इट विल बी -3 + 4. इफ वी सॉल्व इट, इट विल कम +1. इजंट इट? 4 में से 3 माइनस करिए कितना आएगा? 1 आएगा. सो इट इज +1. हेंस दिस चार्ज +1. दैट इज व्हाई द चार्ज इज गिवन NH4+. गॉट इट? आर यू गेटिंग इट? लेट्स टेक अनदर एग्जांपल. लेट्स टेक द एग्जांपल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव रेडिकल. Electronegative. So we have talked about what is electronegative? OH-. OH- is hydroxide ion. Now why there is -1 sign? Let's calculate. The valency of oxygen is minus 2. The valency of hydrogen is plus 1. Now solve. Minus 2 plus 1. It will be minus 2 plus 1. It will be minus 1. Isn't it? This much you know, I think. Minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. Hence the charge minus 1. Got it? Are you getting my point? So, by this the charges are given its name. Hence, we like put it, let's take few more examples. Children, keep this in mind. Keep this always in mind that maximum of the radicals are electronegative. Maximum of the radical that we see is negative in character. There are few radicals that are positive. That is ammonium ion that was positive. Okay. Like this, we also write few names of the radicals. You can see in the table that is given in your book. So, please see this table. So, children, you can see here, see, this is electropositive. Isn't it? Electropositive is written. So, this is electropositive. Alright. So, let's see. This is ammonium. Can you find ammonium? This is NH4 ammonium. And we have valency as 1. Got it? We have barium. Valency is 2. So, there are only few electronegative positive radicals. Okay? These are the elements. They are having multiple valencies. That is called variant or variable valency. This is here written here. Variable valency. Let's talk about this also first. Okay, let's talk about variable valency. What is variable valency? If one compound is having more than one valency, it is called variable valency. Like copper. Copper is having two valencies. Plus 2 also, it is having plus 3 also. Okay, it is having plus 2 and plus 3. Okay, so it can be named, sorry, it is having plus 1 and plus 2, I'm sorry. So, plus 1 will be named as cupric and it will be named as cuprous. Alright, similarly we have two valencies of iron. The symbol of iron is Fe. So, Fe plus 2. And we have Fe plus 3. So, Fe plus 2 is named as ferrous. And Fe plus 3 is named as ferric. Alright. So, they are called variable valencies. So, if any element is having two or more valencies, it is called variable valency. Somebody has asked me in the group about variable valency. That's why I have told you. So now again coming back to electronegative and electropositive radicals, I'll again show you the table. You can again see it in your book. So this was about positive. Now coming on to lift. So see, you can see maximum of the radicals are electronegative in nature and they are given different names. Are you getting it? Let's take few examples. Let's pick examples from here itself. Let's talk about this sulfate, sulfite and sulfide. And let's talk about all these family members. They are alike. Sulfide, sulfite, bisulfite, sulfate, bisulfate. Let's talk about it. So why are they given such names and how these names are changing? Let's talk about it. So, we have first sulfate. So, we have SO4 2 minus. Is it visible? Let me darken it first. So, we have SO4 2 minus. Got it? Now, This sulfur is having a maximum capacity of attaching 4 oxygen. तो जितना मैक्सिमम ऑक्सीजन ये सल्फर अटैच कर पाएगा उसके आगे हम सफिक्स लगाते हैं 8. ओके, सो दिस विल बी सल्फेट. व्हाट वी आर यूजिंग एज सफिक्स, वी आर यूजिंग इट एज 8. गॉट इट? हमने क्या लगाया? ए टी ई 8. गॉट इट? अब क्या हुआ, इसमें से हमने एक ऑक्सीजन को कम कर दिया. हमने क्या लिखा? SO3 2 minus. हमने क्या लिखा? SO3 2 minus. यहाँ पे SO4 था, यहाँ पे हमने लिखा SO3 2 minus. तो जब एक ऑक्सीजन कम हो जाएगा तो यहाँ 8 की जगह 8 हो जाएगा. ITE 8. So the name will be sulfite. Are you getting it? Sulfite. So the name will be ite. I-T-E. Ite. Fine. अगर maximum carbon है, maximum oxygen है, यानी कि ज़्यादा oxygen है, तो यहाँ पे 8 लगेगा. ठीक? अगर एक oxygen कम हो गया, तो यहाँ पे क्या लगेगा? Ite. I-T-E. Ite. Got it? अब अगर ऑक्सीजन है ही नहीं, यहाँ पे हमने सिर्फ S2 लिखा है, S2 2 minus, तो ये क्या हो जाएगा? आइट की जगह आइड लग जाएगा, IDE. So it will be sulfide. IDE. Are you getting it? 8 अगर मैक्सिमम है, 8 अगर एक कम हो गया, ID, IDE, it is ITE and it is IDE. Here we are using T for tiger and here we are using D for dog, isn't it? So this is ITE and it is IDE. Okay, so we have sulfate, sulfite and sulfide. Please look into your table. Please look table 4. So, is it correct? Let's see. See, SO4 with maximum oxygen is 8. What is written here? Here it is written 8. 8 is written. Okay. As the number of oxygen decreases to 1. Here, it is SO3. What is written? Ite is written. I-T-E, ite. Clear? Now, when the oxygen is, when there is no oxygen present, like there is only S, what is written? Ide, I-D-E, ide. Are you getting my point? Now, if we are adding, now let's come back to the board, then you will understand. Okay, now if we are adding hydrogen in front of this, if we are adding hydrogen in front of this SO4 2 minus, first of all there will be 1 minus. If we are adding hydrogen, the charge will reduce to 1. Okay, ek charge kam ho jayega, so it will be S. Ab agar hum yahan pe hydrogen laga rahe hain, to naam iska kya ho jayega? There is sulfate, you will just have to add bi in front of this. So it will be bisulfate. I'll write it again. If you are adding hydrogen in front of it, it will be bisulfate. Got it? Same is the case here. If you are adding hydrogen here and there will be 1 minus. So aise to isko hum sulfite likh rahe the. हमने जब इसको हटा दिया, H लगा दिया, तो it will be bisulfite. Are you getting it? Are you getting this point? So by this way, names are given to the radicals. Okay? So we have talked about sulfate, sulfite, sulfide and Then we have talked about bisulfate and bisulfite. Alright. So you can again go through the table. You can again see this table. And children, accordingly valencies are given. Okay. Now, it is not only about the sulfate. It is same for nitrate and nitrite also. So I'll explain you that. To make it more clear, I'm taking another example. Let's take the example of nitrate and nitrite. Nitrate nitrogen family. Okay. So the maximum number of oxygen the nitrogen can have. The maximum number of oxygen the nitrogen can have is 3. So it is NO3 2 minus. It will be what? NO3 minus. I'm sorry, it will be 1 minus. So we have NO3 minus. Alright. Then we have NO2 minus. Then we have NO2 minus. Okay, so let's name it. Agar maximum oxygen hai, matlab jyada oxygen hai, to hum isko kya naam denge? Nitrate. Hum kya lagayenge last mein? 8. We are adding 8 at the last. This is nitrate. Clear? Oxygen ek kam ho gaya, humne naam kya diya isko? Nitrite. I-T-E. It will be named as nitrite. This is R and this is I. So this will be named as nitrite. Getting it? Are you getting this point, children? So it will be nitrate and this will be nitrite. Same with, let's take SO3 3 minus and SO2, are you able to see? Achha, I'm just erasing it. Let's take another example. We'll have SPO3 3 minus. Then we have PO2 3 minus. Alright. So which, and I'm giving you two options. So the two options are phosphite and phosphate. तो किसका नाम क्या होगा? Quickly tell me. किसका नाम इसमें से phosphate होगा और किसका नाम phosphite होगा? So yes, the first one will be phosphate. Isn't it? क्योंकि इसमें ज़्यादा oxygen है. इसमें oxygen क्या हुआ? कम हो गया. तो इसका नाम क्या हो जाएगा? Phosphite. Alright, so by this way, these are given the names. These radicals are given the names and all these radicals are there in this table. Please go through it once. If you, children, see, valencies will be given in your exam. If these questions are coming, the valencies will be given. Okay, you have to just know the names, right? Names of the compound. Alright, and by this valencies, like the valency of phosphate is 3 minus, here 3 minus, we have 2 minus. So by this way, we have to crisscross the compounds and write the formulas. Alright, so this we'll see tomorrow how we will write the formulas by using these radicals. And if you will learn it, you will be able to solve all those questions. Alright. So that's all for today, children. I hope you have learned something new. If you are not still able to learn it, if you are not understanding it, if you have not understood it any of the way, please do ask in the group. Alright? So that's all for today, children. Thank you and Jai Hind.